Good morning and welcome to the first episode of The Early Show.
On today's segment of Kate May Custody, 30-year-old Vitaly is caught in a crossfire between his co-workers, Slaney and Belasco, over who will take responsibility for his many quirks.
I'm Ella Ronk and this is my co-host,
Maddie Lynch.
So, Vitaly, what are your opinions on Mr. Slaney and Mr. Belasco?
Well, I would say they're pretty much like my best friends and they love me more than anything at all. To give you a comparison, the way I would describe Mr. Belasco and my relationship would be the same way that I would describe the relationship between Luke Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi, or Harry Potter and Dumbledore, or James Bond and James Bond's grandfather. It's that type of sort of love relationship. And I don't know if you guys experienced this, but in high school, you know, my mom always told me that, you know, about how the cool kids one day would look up and they would get to be friends with the smart and the fun, you know, the smart nerd kids. And now that's Mr. Slaney, that nerd kid, getting to really be friends with the cool kid. So, I mean, I'm pretty much like the beyond end all of their existence.
I can see that.
Yeah, it's obvious, I think.
Here they are in the flesh, Mr. Belasco and Mr. Slaney.
Mr. Slaney, how long have you been working here at Lower?
This is my 10th year working here at Lower. I've been in the classroom for 9 years. You may not know, but I'm kind of a big deal around here. I'm known as Slane Dog Millionaire, in case you didn't know that audience. Hashtag baseball, hashtag Tiger Pride. I am probably the coolest teacher that most kids don't know, but they haven't had yet. You know, 80s dance champ, prom king, supervisor, best trip planner the LCMR has ever seen. Definitely by far the most handsome history teacher in the department, just saying. But, you know, I've had a pretty good time here at Lower. You know, I have probably 30 more years to go. Thanks to Mr. Vitaly here reminding me that we're going to be here to the long age of 62. So these first 10 years have been great, and I can't wait for the next 30 with Mr. Vitaly.
So what are your opinions on Mr. Vitaly here?
I mean, him and I are close in terms of, like, physical proximity. Like, we're neighbors in the same hallway. We're also class advisors. I would say he's one of the people that I've gotten really friendly with over the years. He's not from around here, so he's a little different. I mean, you heard his analogy in terms of, like, you know, friendships using comic books and all these weird sci-fi things.
It wasn't even a comic book, not a comic.
I would say I don't even know what it was. That just proves how different we are. I would say we're more like, I'm a sports guy, we're more like Kobe and Shaq. Like, we kind of have to be on the same team to win things, which we win everything because we're that good, but we don't really get along, you know, off camera.
If I could just say something, he knew all about comic books when we were playing Dungeons & Dragons last night.
I can't even spell Dungeons & Dragons. I teach history.
I wasn't even there.
So you said that Slaney was more of a nerd, but he just called you more of a nerd. How do you feel about this?
Sometimes, as my mother used to tell me when I was younger, sometimes people say things they don't mean to help protect their feelings.
I've heard that before.
Sometimes people do that.
That's on you.
Yeah, I don't know what sometime you're referencing. We could definitely pull out yearbooks and check whose clubs he was in versus what I was in when we were in high school. I'm very confident in my masculinity and lack of friendship here. And I don't know where we're going here, but I'm getting a little annoyed. I'm feeling a little pressured. Are you accusing me of something here? Like, what?
No, nothing. Okay. Nothing's been accused.
Yeah, all right. Well, let's just take it down.
All right.
Okay. And then back to Mr. Belasco. Would you say you have any ties to Mr. Vitaly?
I don't know if I'd really use the word tie. I know when you listen to Mr. Vitaly and he kind of brings up those really strange analogies about Dumbledore, I think he looks up to me. I think that he really kind of wants to be like me and tries to emulate that as much as possible.
Totally.
But I think that would be as far as the ties go. I think he's looking forward to me not being here so he can be the main teacher in the English department, and somehow he thinks that that's going to be his role, but I'm not sure that I see that happening.
It's understandable.
What is up?
No, thank you.
All right. So then, How would you explain this picture right here?
That picture.
What?
I was walking down the hall, and he came out of it's not really what it looks like. He came out of nowhere jumping at me. I didn't really know how to handle it, so I sort of froze in that picture. That's a setup. That picture. You have something. You did that. You set that picture up.
No,
I know. No, you sent him there to do that. That was all you.
I was not there.
That's you.
I don't Snapchat or Facebook.
No, that's all you.
Ridiculous. I'm telling you.
I don't know. For somebody who's not athletic, I can't come out of nowhere and jump.
There was probably a step stool. Are you kidding me? We've all seen the Vitaly stride. You are definitely not athletic. You pull your back out just picking up a textbook in class. Are you kidding me? What's that, like 300 calories per Pop-Tart?
It's 150 per Pop-Tart.
Oh, it's 300 per Pop-Tart.
This is you guys setting something up here. This is all your fun and games trying to make
trouble.
Can
we hurry up? Baseball practice starts soon, you know. I got to do real things. All right, let's go.
You're not going to baseball practice. You're going to go to some meeting. You're not going to go to baseball practice. Probably cancel practice.
Meeting up.
So you two can hang out and play Dungeons and Dragons.
Beans.
That's probably what it's going to be.
Dropping bombs.
All right, then. How about this photo?
You gotta be kidding me.
You took that picture. This was all your setup.
That's embarrassing.
Two
grown men? Are you kidding me?
He felt bad because he said his neighbor, which I'm assuming was you, was trying to steal his Pop-Tarts.
It was Rosenberg.
You were trying to take his Pop-Tarts. So I was just trying to make him feel better about what you saw there. This is completely... You're setting up every one of these pictures.
Listen. You guys have
everything he does is trying to be like you. He's trying to emulate his Pop-Tarts. You started the Pop-Tarts. This is all coming from you.
Really bad of you two right now.
I really like Pop-Tarts.
This is pathetic.
This is all coming from you.
So, who do you think is really responsible for your Pop-Tart addiction?
Well, as much as Mr. Velasco has provided me with all this wisdom, I mean, I think it could be Slaney for some reason.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Dude, this is ridiculous.
No.
It's all him.
That was so violent. That was
nuts. You guys are next. I can't.
Hey, everybody, Pop-Tarts.
Hey, everybody loves everybody.
It's all
him. Everybody loves...
Pretty small bite.
So, Maddie, I think it's time.
Yeah.
So, every episode, the producer comes out and gives us an envelope that shows us the true person that is responsible for this.
This.
Thank you, Kate. This person.
Oh, okay. Great.
The envelope says...
Find out who is truly responsible after this commercial break.
Hiya, Bobby.
Hi, Cam.
You want to go for a ride?
Sure, Cam.
Jump in.
I'm a Bobby girl in the Bobby world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
I'm a Bobby.
Markovitz.
That's right. It's me. Thank you. I am responsible.
It's ridiculous. This is crazy.
Yep. Hey, buddy. Hey, come on. I got a present for you.
Nice.
There you go.
Cool.
Enjoy. Listen, I feel bad for the guy. You know, he doesn't eat during the week if it's not at his mom's house. And I'm trying to help him out. So I pick him up a box of Pop-Tarts every now and then. Just trying to look out for him. It's the counselor in me.
Is this you giving him Pop-Tarts in between classes?
Absolutely, that's me. You guys aren't going to take care of him.
We're very good at him. Go around, buddy.
I have a budget. I want to
go. I can't believe everyone is accusing me. This is ridiculous.
Well, look, you're the one that sent the photos of Vitaly on my back trying to get me framed for this.
And you're the one trying to get me
framed. Well, you're trying to say that I had something to do with him. He's sitting here eating Pop Tarts, and all of a sudden it's all you who's doing this problem. Forget this. I'm out of here. This is ridiculous.
Well, good, right?
Anybody have any more Pop Tarts?
Well, quite the ending, and join us next time for The Early Show.